center, dropped down the ice by Gregor. Ryan Reeves on the forecheck, and here's the first Richter scale hit, and we missed. Can't be surprised by this. Arthur Jack Eye, Ryan Reeves, first ever meeting between these two teams in regular season game.
Well, the youngster with a little message sending there. Reeves made a hit earlier on in this shift. They got the crowd into it. 6-0-2 in their last eight season openers. It's a 5-3 win. Brady Tkachuk at the heart of that with Jordan Staal, and they'll have some extra words. Teams will still play two more times this year, both in Ottawa on December 12th and March 17th.
Chipped out to Philip Hedl. Hedl gets up, isn't it? Boom! He went head over heels.
Able to step up. Dahlin with a new 8-year, $88 million contract. Right there with the hit on Hedl. There it is again. Dahlin.
Now, spirited gathering in front of the Philadelphia bench. Gardner Hathaway has plenty to say from the bench. And now punches being thrown as Konecny is obviously rather angry here.
Zito had been tangled up in front of the bench with Stenlund. Eventually, it's Tkachuk that winds up on the seat of his pants, and it looks like a penalty coming against Foligno on the play.
So, Bob. DeMarcus doesn't like.
Petrangelo jumps in. Stevenson back to Hague again. He'll release, and he hit Petrangelo up high, and Alex Petrangelo's hurt. Blood pouring from his face, and Petrangelo heading to the bench, and they're going to take him right into the dressing room. Alex Petrangelo thankfully able to walk off down the tunnel. Here's a look.
There's Petrangelo here. And right there. Boy, tough play. Kind of as Cunning going out to block that shot. You can't really see it. Maybe ramps up. And as you can see, there's Petrangelo trying to get out of the way and hits him right up on the left side of the head.
So obvious concern on the Vegas bench. And it looks like a cut to the forehead for Alex Petrangelo. And
Tarina. Oh, he got down to the ice. That's a penalty on Sandberg. Panthers didn't like that. Behura gets in there. Tkachuk goes after Sandberg. Luckily, Etu's okay. Now two Jets are on Tkachuk. Lowry trying to go at it with him. Linesman in between.
Yeah, Kachuk's got to be careful with that stick. That's another situation there where the Jets just throw it right into the slot area.
Oh, Tkachuk and Scheifele gonna go. Matthew Tkachuk got a couple of shots in. Scheifele went down. Tkachuk wins that fight, and then Scheifele gave him a slash right in the midsection. They didn't call it. Rodriguez moves, cross ice feed. Tkachuk off his stick though. Now he's lost his stick. He's moving 2-on-1. Now he's got up from the bench. Lowry is in. Appleton in front.
Dylan did. It was 79 last season.
Oh, they're on the right-wing bench.
Raymond.
Aceman.
There's a thorn, a bunch of roses, a white jersey, and a sea of red. Oh, baby.
Well said.
He's a...
Woo-hoo!
Free to play. Which the Ducks let the Canes get within two, but had an answer. And now after the whistle, Mindyakov takes a bump, and Gudas is there to come to his aid.
That's Brendan Lemieux went great for Mindyakov.
He threw a punch.
And they're trying to rattle the youngster.
Stefan Nason got in there. I think he and Gudas
are trying to get unclenched here so they can go. This is a full-on line brawl right in front of the Carolina bench right now.
This is all about Carolina being frustrated and trying to change a little momentum here by taking some liberties.
Now to Pettersson for the blast! And that one blocked in front by Sealer and hit him up high. He shakes that off. They won't play dead because they were concerned, but Nick popped right back up.
I think that might have hit him in the helmet, JJ.
I think so.
Pettersson can wire it. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Great play by the official, though, to blow it dead. You just don't know, right? I mean, Sealer goes down, he pops right back up, but
he'll try again. Perfetti takes it off the skate. He is dumped by Englund. And Sandberg's going to go after Englund. Perfetti's backed up. Good to see Sandberg answering. And he takes a couple of heavy shots from Andreas Englund.
Played as well. He stands up for a teammate because of that. That is just a no-go zone. You can't make that hit. Perfetti has to learn to protect himself better as well. There is some responsibility on the man getting hit, but it's just a blatant hit from behind. That's dangerous. So good to see Perfetti to get up on his own. And then Sandberg, you can see the wear marks on him.
Hagel hangs on to the puck, gets it away, they score! A great feed by Hagel, buried by Paul. It's 3-0, but now this is going on. Hagel and Paul and Stamkos got a hold of somebody in there.
Yeah, I'm not sure who that is underneath, but Stamkos got pushed like right backwards. He didn't expect it, and that's what caused the commotion. Nick Paul, who just scored the goals, Sebastian Aho is in there. I don't know if he's the original culprit, but somebody took a shot at Stamkos, and that's when the gloves came off and everybody started piling up. Who's in the middle of all that? Orlov.
So this is going to be a Tampa Bay power play to finish this one off with just 2:56 to go. And Lemieux is, well, you can see what he's saying.
Yeah, I think he's going to get tossed.
No, he just got tossed. He's just been kicked out. So he's going to get his money's worth here.
Well, he's not going to be out in a 3-0 game when they need three goals. So he doesn't care if he gets tossed. He's getting his money's worth. That's his 10 minutes worth.
He's got a little trouble with it. Hangs on. Cuts to the front of the net. Omar threw his stick at it.
That's got to be a penalty.
It is a penalty, but they don't call it. So DeBrusk picks it up. Lacombe marks him. Well, I can't understand why they didn't call that. McTavish comes over, helps get the puck loose. Here's Carlson. 2-on-1 with McTavish. Great pass. McTavish scores! And the Ducks come all the way back to win in overtime tonight in Boston.
Through to Kuznetsov. He hits the Minnesota line across for Carlson. Centers and a great stick by Faber.
Oh my goodness, Milano looked like a lacrosse player. A couple of bumps, stick up in the air. In wide, the other side, Milano. Bump, bump, bump. Look at this, beautiful. Overtime hockey next.
And Vetrano's gonna pressure Durzi. Oh! Runs him into the boards. Durzi gets up, and he's throwing. Down goes Vetrano underneath Sean Durzi. There was not a penalty call coming up on this play.
Okay, is there an instigator? Is there an instigator? That's the question that I have right now.
I looked at both referees. Neither of them had their arm up for a call on Frank Vetrano. Durzi got up and started throwing.
Well, Frank Vetrano, you know, he's a guy that does not slow down into the boards. He drops the glove. There's got to be an instigator on this.
Our timeout. Wow. Jay Woodcroft has called timeout here to gather his team and have a word or two.
You know, it's not just one thing. And Connor McDavid, interviewed last game, was saying it's...
Connor McDavid trying to bring it in front and then bank it off Demko, but it didn't work. In the grill of Demko's role, and Miller and McDavid, and it's climbing a
dropped the gloves with JT Miller, who threw a hard right hand as Hyman was going to the ice. And DeGiuseppe's got McDavid tangled up. That'll draw a reaction from Ryan McLeod.
Yeah, but I mean, McDavid started all this.
Pettersson, shooter, cuts in front, stopped by Skinner. And then McDavid went over top of Suter after the whistle.
Well, he cross-checked him and then fell over top. I mean, this, the top guys for the Oilers are unraveling. They gave the puck away in their own end, pardon me, in the Canucks' end. And there's more pushing and shoving going as Hughes and McDavid. Hughes isn't going to let McDavid get back into it.
That's Toronto's next game Friday, the Hall of Fame game against Calgary. Vancouver's got everything going for them, and here's a giveaway in front, scores! Giroux from Stutzla as Wall cops it up, and that's now a four-point game for Tim Stutzla.
Pretty greasy. Chernak.
That's not a good sight.
Taylor Hall on the ice.
Ooh, that does not look good. A couple of games earlier this season already, and hate to see that.
What you really hate to see specifically is him grabbing his knee.
Oh, and taking those deep breaths on the ice.
Two power plays now for the Kraken. The Avs have yet to get a hold. Avalanche now find themselves again at down by us. Two goals. A penalty is coming up on Tori Luckett and Rampage Oleksiak. Into the inboards, or is there a penalty? Are Tori Luckett in serious distress? On all fours, but Ryker, that was a heavy, heavy hit into the inboards.
Place here, so Luckett at 62. Going in on the far left side, battling for the puck. Oh man. He just got unlucky. He got stuck with his own speed in between a rock and a hard place and just couldn't control himself going into the boards there. That's really not a dirty play.
Moore couldn't make a play, and away with it. Zahorna in on right wing. Got clobbered by Englund. Good hard hit as O'Connor centers. Picked up by Deneau. What a hit by Andreas Englund. And Radim Zahorna is a little shaky as he goes to the bench.
He sees it all the way, but you know what? That's just solid defending by Englund right there. Make sure you take the body, the chest, and that's exactly what happens.
Yeah, he was able to step up there and come across to make that hit because Spence is on the other side. He's got the middle of the ice taken care of.
Here's Lindholm, takes a look, passing. Brzezinski almost bounced in off of the fender, skated. And now it's him, but they blew the whistle. Mad scramble, and we get some rough stuff after the whistle. Lagesson not happy. The Flames were jabbing away as Wall was down. The whistle blew, and the puck did go in, but it did sound like the ref had blown the play then.
Kadri Yellen, that's a goal. That's a goal.
Bobby McMahon on the ice just called up today and will take the spot of Ryan Reed on the fourth line for Toronto. Can't knock down. Big hit there. Dakota Joshua wrapping the gloves, and Joshua being challenged here by Mark Giordano. Only-year-old Mark Giordano up against one of the leading hitters in the NHL. And
he doesn't want it to stop.
Joshua doesn't want the linesman to come in yet.
Could have been a pass for a lot from here, but right. Truba joined the rush.
Yeah, what beautiful passing.
Here's a chance in front. Oh! Marchenko got knocked down by Truba. Truba gets challenged by Fantilli. And Truba's ready to go, but he doesn't have to. That was a clean check.
Totally.
That's
going
to be a penalty on Columbus.
Yeah, totally a clean hit.
Open at the right point is Gudas. He'll wind and fire off of San Jose. Stick! Scored! It floated in the air, and Blackwood never picked it up, and it floated in the net. A lot of guys wouldn't have played it this way.
There it's way up in the air. You see Blackwood, he has no idea.
Stone's fifth full season with Vegas.
Whoa!
Tremendous hit there.
Here they go.
And McElrath are going to drop the gloves. McElrath just drilled Ron Buehr.
Kolesar is their resident top guy. And McElrath, we know of him. And he's one top customer.
McElrath sticks him with a right cross.
Leading that fight. Here's that hit coming up right there. Beautiful. Shoulder to chest. Couldn't get better than that. And he knew with Kolesar on the ice, he's probably going to have to answer. And he did. Right away, Kolesar right over to McElrath. And McElrath knew it was coming. They looked at each other right there. He gave him the first shot.
Dylan McElrath in the lineup. The Capitals still waiting the return of Trevor Van Riemsdyk.
He's talking to Obi at the bench. Obi's cruising around there and he's giving him, oh yeah, that was a good one. And now they're talking chit-chat.
In by Nathan Bastian. Down low. Oh, Trubo with a big hit. Knocks down Tomas Nosek.
Nosek is having trouble getting up.
Boom.
He had his head down and he was looking for the puck. He's going to need some help getting off the ice.
Yeah, he can. He can't get up. Whistle blows, stopping play. And here we go. There's some rough stuff there after Cooley.
Smith, Brendan Smith, right after Cooley.
Cooley, you're good.
But down on the other end is Nosek, who just came back in the lineup. And now Siegenthaler and Cooley. Cooley's a tough kid.
He gets hit by Ryan. Oh, Tkachuk and Bennett through the body of Domi there. Right,
there they go.
It's Domi and Bennett. Domi took the cheap shot at Sam Bennett. And Bennett is throwing the rights at Max Domi. Now Sam Bennett real upset that Domi took that pop at him and he makes him pay there.
Yeah, you knew that was going to happen.
Slick to McAvoy. Balls on Marchand. McAvoy, Mathis, Carpenter, and meanwhile, Marchand is going with Zetterlund.
Doesn't break stride. Tried to get it ahead for Terry. Now Carlson picks it up at center. He's taken down as he comes into the Colorado zone. And an Anaheim power play forthcoming. Frederick Olesen. He's going to go for a trip, and then McDermott comes over and gives Leo a face wash. And Carlson answers back, and everybody meets along the wall.
Yeah. I don't know what McDermott was thinking about, quite honestly. He could have put his team down two men.
Well,
there.
He's getting a penalty here. Kyle Raymond just pointed at him and said, you go to the box.
Skinner over to Middlestep. Caden Cooley right on him to take the puck away. Oposo jumps on him. Slavkovsky trying to pull Oposo back, and everyone's going to pile into the corner. The original penalty coming up to Buffalo here, but the scramble afterwards, we'll see if anything else comes of it, is Justin Barron slow to get to his feet.
They've spent their entire careers in Winnipeg. You look at Ehlers, Connor, Shifley, Morrissey. The big guns, if you will. And here's a backhander in the glove of Gibson, and a penalty coming up to the Ducks. And quickly, Shifley jumps in. And he and Ryan Strome exchange right hands. Strome fought three times last season as a Duck. This is his first tilt of the season. And he does very well against Mark Shifley.
He landed one right on the button there.
Tried to play it back to the line, but it's intercepted by Jack Hughes. And he had his head up because Mitnikoff had him lined up. Well, Mitnikoff and Hughes mixing it up.
Yeah, he's got to get a cross-checking penalty here.
Hughes having words with Mitnikoff as he is taken to the penalty box.
Well, to get that puck over the blue line. Or
oh, boy, Gudas had Koskinen lined up, and Koskinen's in some distress. And Gudas over to check on him. And here come the Ducks with a chance right down the slot. Fired wide. Oh, boy. Mitnikoff had a great look.
Koskinen unable to get back to the bench, so the play is going to be whistled down.
Now, the referees do not stop the play when one team has an advantage.
Had all sorts of room, and now Barbashev and Hagel.
Well, Barbashev laid out Cirelli, and then Hagel wants to fight. Well, they should get the extra. Good job by Barbashev. Little jabs in.
Those jersey jabs. Hagel flail to the right. Barbashev landing a couple. They both trying to land right. Hagel's lost the helmet. Pretty good bout between a couple of guys that don't do this much.
Well, and Barbashev cut him. I mean, good hit. It was a good fight. He said these two guys, kind of a middleweight.
Patrick Corrali back the other way for Columbus. And he's met by McCabe. McCabe trying to work it ahead, but Texier bottled him up. It comes out in front, and Texier picked the pocket of Lilligren, but the lead now able to get it out at least to center. Knocked down was McCabe. Corrali has been shaken up, and he made his way to the Columbus bench and took that, right by the
puck. Took that hit behind the net. He had Matthews on one side.
A real animated Columbus bench.
We've got somebody having a real, they're wanting the medical assistance.
Okay, we've got some issues here at, yes, they're getting the paramedics come out.
We saw Corrali go through, and the Columbus bench has just been yelling, and it's not happening quick enough for them.
No.
The gentleman who's getting across is not doing so very quickly.
Almost surprised that he's going across the ice when there's a tunnel in behind. Let's see what happens.
There's the play. Oh, it hit his head. Did you see the reaction afterwards? And then the puck hit him afterwards. So that hit him right in the chest.
Now Power trying to dig it free. Comes up with it in the far corner. Pitlick on his back. But Eric Johnson is there. He's given a hit. And Johnson, after the hit here by Kurashev, still down on the ice. And the penalty's been called on the play. Pitlick will be the penalized player.
Hit the outside of the net. Picked up by Verhaeghe. Turns, fires, save, and now Lockwood's in a fight with Duhamel. This is a tough customer. And give Will Lockwood credit. He knew it was coming. And against tough Brandon Duhamel, Lockwood trying to stand up well. Duhamel got one in there.
Yeah, you knew he was going to get challenged right away, Lockwood, and he threw some rights. He just stood there. He did not tuck down or try to stop the fight. He welcomed it, and he started throwing them as hard as he could.
It's not like a centerman. You got to go back deep all the time.
Spoken like a centerman. Pellick got clipped by Gallagher. Everyone will come say hello to Brendan Gallagher, but Adam Pellick still shaking up on the ice.
Yeah, don't take a penalty now and negate that opportunity. We'll see if it's going to be two or four, but Pellick's down like it was a pretty good high stick.
Yeah, this, you love a power play, but Adam Pellick more valuable to this team than the next 2 minutes of a hockey game, that's for sure.
Carlson connects to Carter. He'll let it go to Achari. And a rugged centerman takes a big hit from Dillon, had his helmet knocked off, and Dillon draws a crowd. Jansen Harkins right there.
Charlie's in trouble a little bit here. He got hit pretty hard. Noel picking up speed under the puck. He's coming through that neutral zone, just trying to get by. Pionk right there. And then Dillon's coming forward, and you could see head contact right off the bat. Coming in. Goes right through his head, and it's a tough angle when you're coming across like this, and you're leading him as the hitter. That's on you. That's on you.
Schneider meantime into traffic, and Markstrom gets a beat on that, and then Panarin and Pospisil go at it again. Things get testy in New York. What is going on in this city between these two teams? And here we go. Trocheck just jumped into a pile and grabbed somebody around the neck. Lafreniere and Mahal are tied up, and a bit of whatever happened a year ago has crept its way back into this game.
He's out of the box. He's hit right on the money. Here it comes. Arvidsson trying to tie him up. He was a shot. No. Comes back to him. And Rennich keeps it out.
Wow. How do you stop that? It's getting a little nasty. Marchecki's come right out of the box. Pass right up the middle. Arvidsson tries to tie him up. Doesn't take a penalty. I don't know if Jack's mad. He thought he got pumped a little bit by Arvidsson out of the box, but he had a great chance. I'm not sure from that angle if in fact, and Jack is still fired up. One more look at it. Better angle. Let's see if Rennich got a piece of this.
Arms a little wrapped around there.
Great save there. Jack just missed.
Yep. Recovery by Fowler. Mitnyakov brings it back in, drops it off to Zegras. Trevor takes it in behind the net. He scores! A lacrosse goal! Exactly what Alan Lozoff asked for.
Wow! You know, the thing about Zegras, when he does this and executes it, is he's moving. I've seen a lot of guys try it, but not while they're skating at almost full speed. What a play. What a beautiful play by Trevor Zegras. Just amazing. Amazing hands.
I think most of the crowd is just now realizing what he did, because they showed the replay a couple of times.
To the net. Tarasenko couldn't get him there. Now he does. Bobrovsky the save. He's looking forward and they get the whistle. That puck rolled in. And Bobrovsky goes after Tkachuk. Sergei Bobrovsky had enough of the contact.
Long shot down in front. Devils able to play it. And here's Bastion getting by. And he's hit. Whoa, coming over with Trouba. And Bastion chases Trouba and jumps Trouba.
And now Miller into it. He gets slashed by, I think, team's
ability of the heavyweight battle right here. Delorier and Rempe sizing each other up. This started in warm-up.
Stable going into the penalty box, so the linesman right away said, we're going to take you to the other side. And I mean, he's every tough guy in the league is going to challenge him.
And now Reeves and Rippey, is it time? Rippey looked at the bench, but I guess he got the go ahead. A lot of people have anticipated this. Ryan Reeves and the new heavyweight on the block.
Thank you.
The Delorier fight was a marathon. This looks like it's got the makings of a 15-round or two.
Most of the jabs just with the reaching hand that's holding, and what they said, is that enough?
Now Jack Hughes finds room in the middle of the ice, and he gets down. Guess who? Brad Kogutis. Brings Curtis Lazar after Gudas.
What a hit. I mean, the timing of this hit.
It's the goal. And now Tenorti mixing it up after the whistle at the side of the net. Frustration starting to come through as Mrazek joins the fray. The referee tells him to get out of there. Gudas is involved. Initially was McTavish, I believe, and Tenorti, but it's Entwistle and Gudas who get loose. And again, Mrazek comes in there, and this is going to completely get out of hand if Mrazek continues to do this. Here comes John Gibson.
Well, he's got to get Mrazek.
Yeah, he's got to grab the Chicago netminder. He will. Because Mrazek was involved in everything and anything the officials would let him get involved in. So at that point, Reese Johnson bloodied by Pavel Mintyukov. And John Gibson and Mrazek having words, and now Gudas and Entwistle re-engage.
Raymond to Fabry, to Larkin, Fabry again. Korpisalo to save. And now he gets back on his feet as Detroit continues to apply pressure. But we've got a situation here. Larkin is on the ice. He is not moving. This is a scary situation. Dylan Larkin is not moving at all on the ice. They're quickly calling the trainers. My goodness. Right away, you got to hope that he's okay. And this is serious.
In the first period, Zach with it now. Zach feathers a pass, and Goodrow can't get a stick on it. Looked at the official, thought he was hooked.
Yeah, he did.
And long stretch pass here. Locking out of the zone and dished to the far side. Zach felt that he was hooked there as Sider dishes. Now Kane, who's on the ice. Kane from a sharp angle and scores. The net dislodged. Patrick Kane with the shot. They'll take a look at this one, but the Wings pile off the bench and win it in overtime. And still the discussion goes on for the lack of that hooking call.
Pascal Vincent saying, we're not going. We're staying right here on the bench. Johnny Gaudreau is livid. He got hooked in front of the net all alone.
And the announcement of the good goal, the Wings win this one. The Jackets will file off the bench.
And Johnny Gaudreau still has something to say to the ref, because he is going to get right there, right here. He's going to give him another 10-minute penalty here for Johnny Gaudreau. Well, we saw that. He had a clear-cut break in front of the net. He got hooked, and he is not happy here. But the Red Wings fans and the Detroit Red Wings.